Well, let's talk a little bit about Harper. 257, 17 homers, and 67 runs batted in. And he had a career or season high, 5 runs batted in tonight.
Yes.
I mean, he's still, over the last 70 games, I mean, he could put up MVP-type numbers carrying this Philly team.
He's that type of player. He's 1 month away of putting up Bryce Harper monster numbers, ending up 39, 40 home runs. I'm telling you right now, I've been saying it all year, he's going to have that month when he carries a team. He does it every year. This could be the month. Tonight's a big sign. 17th home run and 5 RBIs. He's one of those guys. Home runs are contagious with him. When he finds his swing, he takes off in a hurry.
Yeah, and shouldn't worry about the contract they're living up to, because you can't get a measure dollar for dollar with wins and performance, but it's moments like this. It's interesting, his 9th career walk-off hit, but only his first since 2017, 2 years, and that's just what you said. They don't let superstars beat you in most cases, but Jansen had no choice.
He had no choice tonight, but, you know, and Bryce has been struggling. And, you know, Jansen with that cutter, he likes to get in on lefties, so he's not afraid to pitch him. But, you know, tonight's a good big night for Bryce.
Yep. Let's talk about the comment from Gabe Kapler. Should he show more emotion? He said, I'm not going to be Dallas Green. The Phillies have been a disappointment after having a division lead early. They're falling behind the Braves. What can he do, and what does a player expect from a manager
in
that spot?
Chris, I totally understand where Gabe's coming from. Modern-day athlete, you know, they're not into yelling and screaming, but you know what? You're playing in Philadelphia. Philadelphia is a passionate city. They love the Phillies. They get excited when they're at a game. They're just like the New York Mets fans. So, you know what? To show a little passion back once in a while, fans love that. And there's nothing wrong with showing your teammates, hey, look, I care, and they probably know he cares. But, you know, you're allowed to get angry once in a while. You're the guy that's being accountable for the way the team is playing. So, hey, look, if you're satisfied, you know, sometimes they can be satisfied. So there's nothing wrong with being angry once in a while.
Yeah, back-to-back nights, Kapler's been out and tonight ejected. But how does a player on that team respond? You got to make sure the manager's not overdoing it or that he's authentic.
I'll be honest, is a fine line there for new managers because of the age of now the players. You know, 25 and a half was the average age of the All-Star game. When I came in the league, you were lucky to be in the league at 23 years old, 24 years old. So if he doesn't scream and yell, he's got to find another way to get him. Sit down one by one, talk about things to motivate these guys. But yeah, in Philadelphia, he is the manager. He's going to take a lot of stress when they're not playing well.
Showing he has his players back, and it is now 3 games over 500 for the Phillies. Dramatic win after it looked like the Dodgers were going to pull this out. So if Kluber comes back, you know where they are. And you were part of a team, Terry, that just got in it with great pitching, made it all the way to the World Series. So now the Indians, do they have to rethink? We kept saying, well, they're going to slip, they're going to slide, and they'll trade some people away here. What do you do if you're in the Indians' front office?
Well, we talked about, you know, with the fact they didn't have Kluber and they lost Carrasco, that their pitching was suspect. But you know what? If they get Kluber back going down the stretch, you got Ramirez probably is going to have a bigger second half than he did in the first half. I don't sell. Those kind of guys, if you're talking about Bauer and some of the other guys on Cleveland that, hey, look, they're going to bring you some prospects. They're going to bring you prospects in the wintertime, too. But, you know, that one of the things about the wild card, it's kept the baseball fan excited. And if the Cleveland Indians, if they can keep it going, I'm not saying they're going to go buy some players, but if they stay in this, I just think it's great for baseball.
I wouldn't sell either because it's more of a future for them. After being depleted with injury this year, Kluber coming back, I think, is still a little risky, because he did break the right arm, his pitching arm. I would be very careful with that. This guy's a very special pitcher. But if somebody blow them away for a deal, for Bauer, I think it's something you have to look at.
Yes, you can set a high price.
If you can pull back 2 or 3 great young prospects who can fill in the next year and a half in the big leagues, I think they would make that move, because this guy Bauer can help anybody. He's one of those pitchers that always on a mission. So I think he'll be a great 3-4 guy or 2 guy for any team in baseball.
Yeah, a personality that can be challenging for some.
He can pitch.
I always think Terry, he can pitch. And so all the teams that need pitching, and we've been talking about them all night, hey, why not give it a shot? They right now, Cleveland, would have the other wild card spot with Tampa Bay and could be within 5
Don't sell. I mean, but somebody come with a package with 3 players I know going to be in the big league in a hurry and for our future, especially with a team that has limited resources. I would think about it.
All right. Terrific job by Terry Francona through the first half, and now Cleveland contending.